we're here in the hotel in Cancun where a lot of the Indigenous Caucus members are staying during the Cancun conference. And with us is, on the far left there is Karen Abella. She's been an IFG intern for the past few months and she's here in Cancun with us. She's from Oaxaca but lives in the U.S. And in the middle is Marcelo Carrion from Mexico's campesino organization called Unorca CN. And he has been working with us very closely. In a couple days from now, Marcelo is going to bring 3,000 of his members from the Zona Maya, that's the Mayan territory that surrounds Cancun, to Cancun, which is hours away, but he's got them all on buses, and there is a big mobilización, a big mobilization that is in play for the 7th. It's a couple days from now, which IFG and Marcelo's organization have been involved in. And Marcelo, you just gave me this pamphlet here, and it says mobilización. Can you explain what's this mobilización campesina indígena popular?
Bueno, muchas gracias.
En dos o tres minutos nada
sí,
más.
Sí, muchas gracias. Es para todos nosotros los indígenas de México muy importante esta reunión en Cancún.
Corte, ella puede traducir.
Bueno, esta movilización es para toda la gente aquí de Cancún, de parte de la...
In English.
Oh, okay. I'm sorry. This mobilization is here for from all the indigenous people here in Cancún.
Porque vamos a venir a decirle al mundo que nosotros sabemos manejar los bosques, sabemos convivir con ellos.
This is because we want the world to know that this mobilization is for all people to know how people in the indigenous communities live and how climate change has been affecting it.
Porque también tenemos que decirle a los países industrializados que ya no tienen que seguir haciendo mucha contaminación.
Because we want the world to know that these developed countries don't need to have all the effect on the world. They need to realize that they're actually making a great impact.
Porque también tenemos que decirles que los derechos de los indígenas y de su madre tierra tienen que ser respetados.
They need to know, these developed countries, that the rights of the Mother Earth need to be there. They need to be taken care of and they need to be heard.
Porque nosotros sí sabemos vivir en armonía con la naturaleza y porque siempre vamos a estar vivos juntos con la naturaleza.
Because we, the indigenous people, know how to live with it. We know how to take care of it. So we need to have the developed countries know this.
Por eso los campesinos de México nos hemos organizado para unirnos con todos los campesinos del mundo, con todos los indígenas del mundo.
That is why the indigenous people here in Cancun and all the peasants have gathered together here to let the world know what we want.
And, Marcelo, please explain a little bit about the drought and how it's affecting the corn crops of your members in the Zona Maya. Por favor, explica un poco sobre la sequía y cómo está afectando las milpas de sus miembros.
El problema de la sequía es muy grave en la zona de México, en el sureste, porque ya no llueve a tiempo, ya no hay cosecha.
The problem of the droughts is really important here in the south of Mexico, especially in the Cancun area, because there has been very little rain, so it has given a lot of dry land.
Y este es producto del calentamiento también de la tierra, y le estamos pidiendo al gobierno de México y a los gobiernos del mundo que tenemos que buscar nuevas formas de producción de alimentos para los indígenas y para los campesinos.
We want the government of Mexico to know that there needs to be new ways to fight this drought. There's not only our problem, but it's their problem too.
Que tenemos que tener una economía diferente a donde se privilegie a la producción de alimentos para que vivan los indígenas y los campesinos.
We need them to know that there needs to be a change. There needs to be a change in economics that it's based on producing a better food and a better crops.
Eso hace que tengamos mucha gente muy pobre, que tengamos gente desnutrida y que tengamos muchos problemas en nuestro país México.
These droughts have been affecting the people in Mexico, and so we need it to be taken care of.
Y que a veces el mismo gobierno en su desesperación no sabe qué hacer, y hemos tenido enfrentamientos muy fuertes, y ya no queremos este tipo de enfrentamientos. Queremos soluciones donde participe el gobierno y participemos los indígenas y campesinos.
That is why we need to have people from all the world and all the indigenous areas to be together and fight this.
Okay, thank you, Marcelo. Keep in touch. We'll keep bringing you voices just like Marcelo's from Cancun, like this as often as we can. Thank you.
Thank you.